The 3+3 program allows students to complete 2 degrees in a shortened period of time. What it does is it takes advantage of the fact that a lot of programs like the engineering program and the law school have some commonalities, and a student can finish their engineering required courses in 3 years, start law school in the fourth year, what would be the fourth year of engineering, and actually complete both the first year of law school and the fourth year of engineering at the same time.
I always wanted to be an attorney from elementary school. When it came time to go to college, my parents strongly encouraged me to major in engineering. They wanted me to major in something I could get a job in, and I was good at math and science, so they pushed me towards the engineering school, and I'm really glad they did. It's been a great degree for my law career.
The thing that excites me the most about this is just the overall emphasis on science and technology and the STEM subject matter, because every day you read articles about how important that is through our education system and through our economic system, and there's so much emphasis placed and being placed every day on the importance of training American students in particular to keep up with the rest of the world in the science and technology fields.
An exciting aspect of this program is that it encourages more students to obtain an education in a technical background and obviously go to law school, but whether they go to law school or not and whether they become patent attorneys or not, I think it will be a benefit to our society to have more people with technical training.
It allows you the ability to talk to those folks that are scientific and engineers, because you understand where they're coming from. Some people say that engineers don't communicate well. Well, they do within their spectrum of what they're talking about. Same thing with doctors in their field of expertise. And having a law degree and an engineering degree allows you to be able to think, well, where are the areas that I like to talk about? How can you engage them in those conversations?
In just the civil aspect of law, if you're taking depositions of an expert witness in the same car wreck, and that expert witness is not necessarily a PhD, but somebody who has training and experience and background in a certain topic. And they're opining about it, giving their opinion about that. Well, what happens with your engineering background is you realize when that expert is going a little too far. They really can't say that. And so what that prepares you to do in that deposition is to ask the questions that show the court that that person should really be qualified as an expert. It really helps in that. It's been paramount.
I know several engineers who are principals in large consulting firms who got their law degrees later, but they wound up, like in the environmental field, having to deal with so many statutes and regulations. Then they got their law degree to support their engineering work and their engineering practices.
In my career, more so maybe than others, I used my engineering training and my legal training every day.
We don't want to lose a good engineering student to a law school out of state. And so if we can keep them here by having a program that allows them to shorten the time and the cost for their degree while still giving them a really great quality education, that's to everyone's benefit.